I'm a licensed sex therapist. So being a therapist,
I'm really curious about Zane.
Because at first you go, God, this guy's trouble. But then you look closer and you go, okay, wait a minute. Look closer at those tattoos. He's lost somebody. There's a death date of somebody on his arm. And he's got the serenity prayer on his hands. So part of me is kind of hoping, this guy's got some story. And if nothing else, I'm curious about his story.
I just had this gut instinct about Malcolm.
He's young, but he's wise.
And instantly, we just clicked. And it was like, what are you feeling? Here's what I'm feeling. So
as long as my alliance with Malcolm holds true, I'm good.
Have you talked to Zane about the idol at all?
No.
We're 95% sure Russell has it.
Damn. Right now, there's this feeling that Russell had maybe found an immunity idol, and so Zane might have a shot to stay. But, you know, nothing against Zane, but this is not the point in the game where you can have weak players. You know, God, it just sucks having to make this decision.
Oh, man.
If we don't win immunity, she's got to go home.
Apparently, Roxy sees Malcolm and Angie as this couple, as this big threat, you know, kind of, hey, we need to split that up.
But Malcolm and I are in an alliance.
I think part of it's just a 24-year-old guy snuggling up to something that is really nice to snuggle up to.
But now it's like there's these huge targets on their back. My priority is tonight not having water coming through our roof. I mean, the roof has been great, but when it started raining last night, I mean, we had this like one just sieve, and I'm like, ah. Lovely Roxy on my tribe. She was just all over this morning, like all about, gotta boil our underwear, gotta boil our, I'm like, really? You're gonna be out here for 39 days. Like, just take them off. Like, seriously, take them off, rinse them in the water, hang them up. I know they're gonna be gross, they're gonna be nasty. Roxy is sitting by that darn fire, and that's kind of what she does. I mean, she's a little pot stirrer. Right now, my whole job is be a workhorse, become a value for my tribe. So, yeah, I don't see her as having as much value all around at this point.
Roxy, she's praying for, like, sunshine from God. If it works, we're fantastic. I'm respectful, but it's just not my gig. I don't pray for anything. Anything that's going to get me to the end of the game, it's going
to
be me.
All right, let's just get ready to kick some butt. Period, end of discussion.
We have another challenge coming up. And not once does my mind go to, God, help me win this challenge. No. Dig in, dig deep, and make it happen.
At this point,
Roxy and Russell are definitely aligned. And I know Malcolm and Angie are aligned. And I'm caught in the middle of all of it. I can't put my finger on it, but there is something just about Roxy that I just don't trust. But at the same time, even though I've got my alliance with Malcolm, I mean, if somebody's snuggling and I'm the odd one out, I'm on the bottom. I mean, and I don't want to be on the bottom.
Maybe I give Malcolm too much credit.
Right.
Like in the sense of, please be a strategic player. Please don't be blinded by the headlights. Like, please.
The problem is there's pros and cons to keeping both. But I've got to do what's best for me. And so again, I feel pretty sure about what my vote's gonna be, but it's a long way to tribal council, and I'll have to figure it out.
Malcolm and Angie.
There was such a focus on Malcolm and Angie, you know, as a couple at tribal council, but I'm still holding that trust that it's Malcolm and I, and when the time comes, he'll cut Ange. Because it's a numbers game, I feel much stronger having Russell, because we have to win a challenge.
I know. We know you did.
At least you can.
I think it would be a ridiculous choice to keep Angie at this point. But I don't know that I could get Malcolm to vote Angie.
And then Russell. Russell couldn't climb a ladder.
Maybe he needs to go home. Oh, it's, you know, having three people in a tribe, you know, at day nine, this is not what I envisioned at all.
I have to go on a walk right now. I'm just going
to sitting in our shelter this morning, you know, the rain's coming down and the three of us are in there, and you know, we joke and we're making jokes and having conversations, but then you'll get that silence. And my thoughts aren't on like, oh, missing home yet. My thoughts are on, how do I stay here? Who's going home? And you know, in college I did have roommates, and we had three. And with three, there's always one that's out. You know, the minute I don't take all my stuff to tribal council will be the night I'm probably going home.
Went up the beach when we had a momentary break in the rain, gathered some wood, and I came around the corner, and I don't know why, but it just seemed a little shady. Russell was at the very corner of our shelter, and he was putting a banana leaf there, and he kind of said like...
Then I saw a banana leaf blow. Exactly. And I'm like, oh, did that just come from there? So I was like, let me go over and see what's going on.
I don't know, but it definitely kind of planted a little seed of, What are you doing? I've got my alliance that's with Malcolm, and I hope it's strong. For me, it's strong.
But if Russell has the immunity idol, it's not good. And, you know, I don't want to have to draw rocks. I don't want to have to re-vote. I mean, I don't want to have to go there. So right now, we're trying to get Russell to think that he's the swing, or to think that he's comfortable so that if he does have an immunity idol, he doesn't play it. Yes, I'm a Midwesterner. Yes, I have faith in human beings. I have to. That's what I hang on to. And if I get bamboozled tonight, you know, it's not going to shake my faith that these are two good guys. It'll tell me that, you know, I screwed up and they played the game better than me. We don't know what's going to happen now that we're down to two. Maybe it's going to be like a reshuffling of the deck. But immunity idol's still here. And so we started looking all over. If it's in our camp, where would it be?
Here's the fingers.
Oh my God. We did just find a hidden immunity idol. But, you know, it was frustrating because if we're absorbed to the same tribe, great. We can figure out a way to use it to our advantage. If we're split, Malcolm's got the idol in his possession, and I'm on my own. Just to be in a new family and in a new tribe is great.
Well, welcome.
Thanks, guys. And trying to kind of blend in with my new family here, kind of figure out what my role can kind of be. I'm just really glad to be a part of your guys' tribe. I really am. So whatever I can do to help, I mean, whatever I can do to prove that I have value, even if it's keep me around for one more tribal, then I can regroup. One more, you know, every step is an opportunity to regroup and turn things around. I'm a part of a tribe that has lost again. It's just, it's heartbreaking. So I'm worried. I haven't had 13 days to bond with these guys. I don't know if they're gonna go loyalty or if they're gonna go logic. I'm just thankful to be back. It's scary because as the numbers dwindle, there's less and less place for anyone to hide. You know, we all kind of made the agreement of let's get cleaned up first. We had to look like the freak show coming off the beach because, you know, just mud, you know, for the three of us was just coated in places you wouldn't think it could get to. There's this table full of just sandwiches and brownies and things to drink.
Who wants orange? Anyone else for orange?
I mean, it's just like, you know, our bellies haven't had this kind of food for 2 weeks. Mm.
There's a hammock if anyone wants it.
You know, Jonathan went to go lay over on the hammock and saw something sitting on the table.
You guys, I'm gonna bring you something. I'm not sure what's in it, but it may be really cool.
Jonathan comes over and I just knew. I knew what it was in these envelopes, and it was our letters from home. Coming to this reward, it's motivational fuel, it's emotional fuel that makes any rice that we gave up totally worth it, because now there's this different motivation to just keep going.
We gotta give you a break from this tribal nonsense.
Oh, I know.
I don't wanna go back.
Do every damn one.
Seriously, screw that.
Coming back from the sixth tribal council in a row, I'm just glad I'm back, but it's like deja vu. It's just one after the other. I'm wondering, am I cursed? You know, have I brought something to this tribe?
Clothes. What about our kindling?
Calabac, we're gonna stay four strong. We need two to shift that balance and have the majority. So my plan is to stick with the alliance that I've got going with Calabac, but at the same time, I truly would like to go back to my original alliance with Malcolm.
Oh, you guys.
On the reward, it was really a great group to have on the reward. We got to go down the river on the boat and just eat.
Just a few ribs, guys. I mean, I don't even know.
I don't even know if there's enough.
I'm so happy right now.
Just to savor bite after bite.
That's who I would have wanted to have been at that reward with, because they're a pretty positive group that has meshed together. Well, it was nice to be with them. Should I tell Penner artists?
Tell us who artists. I think that's artists. The best thing.
You know, right now, I've got my alliance with Malcolm and the former Calabao tribe, Carter and Jonathan. And the goal for tonight is definitely to get rid of one of the original Tang Dang members, break that little empire up, and then really continue to just turn this game. But the plan very much hinges on Scoopin' and Lisa. If we can't get the numbers, Jonathan is going home.
And it was like an oasis.
So we were having a pretty quiet day, pretty relaxing. And then Abby came back from the reward and was like, ugh.
Oh, I don't want to cook, but I definitely do want to eat. I don't want to starve to death.
You have lost your freaking mind, girl. Part of me just thinks, that's fine. Just let it piss everybody else off. You know what? Your time will come. And I may not get to tell her anything until I'm writing her name down and it's that tribal council that she's finally walking out and I get to say, you know what? Whiners are wieners. You need to go home.
It wasn't cute. You understand that? All right, thank you.
Abby was sitting by the fire with Michael, and as we're overhearing it, it's just more of the same. She just continues the reign of negative, grumpy Abby.
Are you having any of this?
Hearing all, but I just lay there and listen for a while.
I only heard pieces, but when did I hear something?
It's just, look, she's still furious, defensive, bitter.
Between Michael and Malcolm and Lisa and I, we have our solid four. Abby is the one going next. Unless she miraculously wins immunity, which I doubt. I highly doubt it. But if she does somehow have immunity, Jonathan's made it this far. He's a great player. Our next bet would probably be we vote out Jonathan.
For tonight's tribal council, we still have our four, the four tight alliance between Malcolm, Michael, Lisa, and myself. And, you know, we're looking at two players that we want to vote out, you know, Abby or Carter. And for myself, you know, I'm just like, get Abby out, get Abby out, get Abby out, because just the negativity, we just can't stand her at this point. Carter kind of gave his appeal today of, you know, why he really just hopes that we'll consider keeping him over Abby, and that's the kind of speech that can win this game. He's shown himself to be a strong player, and Abby, as much as I would love to have her gone, ultimately the smart vote is to vote out Carter. You know, he had said, you know, out of respect for the game, keep me. Out of the respect for the game is why he needs to go. It is not a cultural thing. It's her personality, and there wasn't a single one of us sitting there that didn't go. And now you've just given us the very reason we need to vote you out, because it's this histrionic, dramatic, passive-aggressive, martyr. It's not culture, it's the culture of Abby.
I was really heartbroken, really.
It's gonna be a painful afternoon. It's like the first date with the kid who like pulled your hair all the time in kindergarten or like spit in your lunch, and then suddenly you're on a date and it's like, wow, okay, so I'm just gonna make nice.
Oh, Abby, I'm sorry. I know you wanted to go.
I wanted to go so badly. It's just like, I am literally the swing vote here, and I don't think that Michael sees it. It's kind of weird.
I know.
It's like, I just want to get to the end of the date, and so I'm gonna let her strategize. I'm gonna let her talk about how she's the swing vote.
So yeah. You never know what's gonna happen at immunity, you know? You never know who's gonna win.
That's true.
Next tribal is my last chance to play my idol.
That's true.
She keeps talking about having the hidden immunity idol. None of us believe she has one, not even for a minute. But it's just trying to get through the afternoon and make it as tolerable as it can be.
But anyways, food for thought.
Food for thought, for sure.
I want to hang myself, gouge my eyes out. If I could have like needles that could just go right into my eardrums, I'd be good for the afternoon. This morning I got up, and as soon as I moved, there's sharp, incredible stinging. It was like my whole neck was on fire right here. It's just ache and pain, like this hurts to just even lift my arm or to move my neck. So I don't know if I'm having an allergic reaction to something that bit me.
That could be a poison.
I've got like fang marks somewhere in my neck here. So clearly it wasn't a mosquito. I'm trying to tell myself to suck it up because you have 3 days left. Like seriously, if it's just an allergic reaction that'll pass, then we're good. But I just don't know what it is. I don't know if it was a spider. It could have been a little lizard. There are tarantulas out here. We've seen scorpions. We've seen a snake, you know, going up the tree. You forget that, you know, there's stuff everywhere out here. So I'm just hoping it passes. It's not gonna kill me, but it's really, really painful right now. Knowing that Malcolm won and it wasn't Abby was a huge relief. Tonight is a slam dunk. There's no other name that I'll be writing down other than Abby's. And the torture of dealing with her will be done. Oh, we have a challenge today, which we weren't expecting. My fear is I will be the next one to go. We've had the solid four, but four can't go to three. So I am desperate to win it because one of us is gonna get the short end of the stick. And I definitely don't want it to be me. I've tried to approach Malcolm about going to the final three together. And he's just very hesitant to make any kind of commitment. And so for me, knowing that he had planned so hard to make sure we had a six and had planned so hard to make sure we had a four makes me very leery about his thoughts on keeping me in that final three. So this is kind of scramble time. And I need to figure out a plan and figure it out fast. My plan will be Malcolm. with the hopes that you two stay on that. I mean, that's, I'm 100% on.
Maybe. You would be silly.
I 100%.
To do anything else.
I am so mad. Malcolm and I could have stayed together and split the boat, have it be a tie, but now that's not gonna happen. So my head is clearly on the block tonight.
You got it right, Malcolm.
It's guaranteed. The problem is Scoopin is kind of the dreamer guy. His mind's going 1,000 different places, and he may not always see the repercussion of what happens if you take the best of the best of the best to the end. So I have to figure out a way to convince him that it's worth it to take me with them. I am one stubborn, determined woman. And if I can make it happen, I'm gonna make it happen.
Yeah, I'm really mad.
I feel badly that Malcolm is really upset, but at the same time, this is that part of the game when I can say, you know, Malcolm, you are a great ally. You played a great game, but this is the part where I outwit you. Because he really sounds like he believed, like, absolutely, he was going to that final three. This is the part where I went one step past you, and you can be angry, but that's the game.
Outwitted, outplayed, outlasted, no matter what anybody says.
You did. Being here with Michael and with Lisa, along the way, we have developed great friendships that will last outside of this game. It was really a great moment to just stop and truly, you know, just set the game aside, be with people that you really respect and enjoy their company.
Take it all in. I'm glad I didn't miss this.
It was great to hike up to the cliff this morning, you know, to have the three of us and just to sit up here and have a different perspective.
Who knew that in 39 days, such significant life change could happen, such deep connections could be built?
Here I am, this little old sex therapist from Cedar Rapids, Iowa, that everybody thinks is probably gonna blow it on coattails, who actually has played some strategy. And I feel like I'm thriving out here.